Imagine a battlefield. On the good side, we have our immune system and good bacteria. On the bad side, we have virus and bad bacteria. If the bad side wins, we get sick. How can we make sure the good side wins in this battlefield?
We all live and co-evolve with millions of so-called commensal bacteria, or good bacteria, which protect us from diseases without us even noticing. Tran Du and her research team want to find out which ones are the good and bad bacteria in vaginal tract, and how good bacteria can protect us from infections such as human papillomavirus, in short HPV.
Microbiome is microorganisms that lives together with us from birth to death. And you can find microbiome everywhere, from our skin, in our gut, in our oral and vaginal tract. And it also includes everything that produced from the microorganisms, the proteins or compounds that secreted from them.
Almost everyone is infected with HPV at some point in his or her lifetime. And HPV is the world's most commonly sexually transmitted infection. If good bacteria, together with our immune system, could help us combat HPV, we'd have a much better chance to defeat the infection. If not, diseases may develop, which can lead to cancer.
Currently, there's no treatment for HPV infection. Most of people get warts and clear the HPV infection within 1 or 2 years.
In Sweden, all boys and girls are offered vaccination against HPV. The vaccine significantly decreases the chances of developing cervical cancer or anal cancer if you get an HPV infection.
HPV vaccine program in Sweden has done a great job and significantly decreased the cervical cancer cases in Sweden. In our study, we found there were other HPV types start to get prevalence among the Swedish young women, and these HPV types are not covered in the HPV vaccines.
Jean Du's group tries to find the answers from clinical data. The group has collected hundreds of genital microbiome samples, extracted the bacterial DNA, and discovered unique patterns via sequencing and bioinformatics analysis in both health and disease conditions. Finally, the good and bad bacterial candidates are documented.
So there are lots of things we don't know in this field. My group is working on from the very beginning. We collect clinical samples from different people, including healthy ones and the ones that are related to HPV infection. So by observe what has been changed in the microbiome from healthy to the disease condition, we can find what has been changed and what are the good bacteria and what are the bacteria that related to disease or infection.
Juan Du and her team also study the mechanistic details. They put the good and the bad sides together and follow the fight between the microbes in order to see which side wins and which weapons the winner uses to defeat the other side.
So what we are looking at now is anaerobic hood. So within the hood, there's no oxygen at all. We know lots of the gut microbiome and vaginal microbiome. They are living in the anaerobic condition. Both good and bad bacteria can interact with the cell in the anaerobic condition. So we put them together and now the fight starts. And then we'll follow them up with different ways.
By identifying how good bacteria can defeat threats naturally, or how we can weaken the bad bacteria, Juan Du hopes to find probiotic products to improve the health of the vaginal microbiome, reduce the use of antibiotics, and to strengthen our body against HPV infection and its related diseases.
We also test our hypothesis in the bioprinted 3D model we developed in the group. And after we test our hypothesis in 3D level, we hope to find some probiotic candidates or the protein or the or metabolites they use as the potential medicine. Hopefully with what I'm studying right now, we could find some candidates that could help the people that are suffering HPV persistent infection or HPV related disease.
Bacterial vaginosis is a condition with unbalanced vaginal microbiome. The current treatment for bacterial vaginosis is antibiotic treatment, but with high recurrence rate.
with the current antibiotic resistance, we try to find a replacement. These are commensal bacteria that we live with, so they do much less harm than antibiotic, for example. Your body already has the way to fight against the virus. If we can strengthen the healthy microbiome, in this case, we can fight with our own commensal or good bacteria against disease without any other antibiotic treatment.